Learning from observation, a small data approach to human common sense. And currently, many senior in assisted living facility would have preferred to remain at home. If caregivers can teach service robot just from demonstration, such robot can learn how to perform tasks customized to that environment, and such robot can help seniors to enjoy their living at home and empower them to be able to achieve more. Toward this goal, we are developing a system called Learning from Observation. The robot can understand what to do and how to do from one single demonstration. In this paradigm, there are a couple of the challenges exist. One challenge is difference in kinematics and dynamics between human and robot. Let's suppose robot has a perfect knowledge of human performance. However, even though we provide such information to robot, without understanding the key point, this kind of failure occurs. The error coming from direct mimicking due to the kinematic difference and dynamic difference between human and robot. And in order to avoid this situation, we are developing a system to extract key point representation from demonstration and map that one to robot performance. Issue is how to obtain such key point. Currently, two approaches exist. One is bottom-up approach and the other is top-down approach. In bottom-up approach, learn everything from scratch, from many physical demonstrations. While top-down small data approach designs a key point based on robotics and mathematical theories, which we accumulated from past. And then, based on such a key point knowledge, we can mimic the action from a single demonstration. And in fact, this kind of approach pushes the science to understand ourselves too. So we are using this top-down approach. Another challenge in this environment is cluttered environment. And traditionally, robot works well-organized environment without human around. However, in this service robot paradigm, robot is working in cluttered environment, close contact to human. So, robot need focus of attention. And we are providing such focus of attention from multimodal demonstration. Namely, teachers can verbally explain their demonstrations. And based on such verbal instruction, focus of attention is guided. And even if necessary, robot can ask a question to the teacher to clarify the situations. That is a basic approach. Now, today's agenda consists of four topics. First, I will explain one of our baseline system and task model design. And then we introduce three tools to represent common sense. Lava notation to represent common sense in body motions, and the semantic constraint to represent common sense in two environmental relations, and grasp contact webs to represent common sense in grasping. Now let's take a look at the baseline system. And this baseline system consists of three phases. One is offline design phase, and second phase is online teaching or demonstration phase, and third phase is online execution phase. And first, let's take a look at this offline design phase. In this offline design phase, we design task models, and we define household tasks as an action to cause state transition of the particular target object. For example, in this case, cup is a target object. Previously, cup is no contact with any environmental object, and then once cup is placed, this cup has contact with the table. So, place task is an action to cause state transition from no contact to prana contact. And a non-contact or prana contact is state. We define six states following from Mason's joint contact. Non-contact, prana contact, prismatic contact, one-way prismatic contact, revolute contact, and one-way revolute contact. And among these six states, there are 10 state transitions. So we can define 10 tasks. For example, NC to PC, this is corresponding to place task. PR, prismatic to one-way prismatic. PROP is drawer close task. And RVOR is a door closing task. And to each task, we prepare task models. Each task model has state transition, of course, and then there are slots which describe how to perform such task. And corresponding, such as in object positions or hand positions. And corresponding to this slot, we also prepare daemon functions to collect such parameter from image. And also, we prepare a demo to exec method to convert demonstration coordinate in the teaching mode to the execution coordinate in the execution mode. Now, issue is how to associate input demonstration to task model. And for that, we prepare a verb and task association tables. Verbal input is put, that is NC-PC. If verbal input is pick up, PC-NC likewise. This is a design method, how we design task model. Now let's take a look at how we use this task model in teaching mode. In online teaching mode,
pick a bird cup and place it on the shelf.
And then demonstrate. From this verbal input, recognize pick up red cup, that pick is PCNC and place is NCPC, and target is red cup. Then PCNC task is invoked, and then task model is instantiated. And then to each slot, there is a daemon, get object name daemon from verbal input, that guy get red cup and plug in that value to the slot. And then, based on this red cup information, get object position daemon, search entire image, and recognize the red cup in the image, and localize it using Microsoft Custom Visions. And also, around that object, system makes a bounding box to detect other action to this particular object. Likewise, there are other daemons, such as grasp type, object positions, object directions, rotation axis. Likewise, daemon is also existing on the slot. And those daemons are guided by spatial focus of attention and temporal focus of attention. Now, once we obtain this task model that is given to the robot, and robot can execute likewise. We introduce some of the basic tools to represent the common sense on top of this baseline system. And in fact, you know, when performing a task sequence, humans implicitly take an optimum posture sequence to execute such task sequence. And to teach such optimal task pose sequence, it is necessary to represent human body actions. And for example, this is a sketch given by a dance teacher to dance so-called Japanese folk dance called Ice Bandai-san dance. And in fact, this key sketch contain key concept how to dance this one. The issue is how to extract this kind of key point and how to describe them. And in dance community, there is a representation called Lava notation, data compression method along human perceptions. That is invented by Rudolf Laban around 1927. And this Lava notation consists of a symbol and a diagram. And in this Lava notation, time flows from bottom to top, and each column of Lava notation corresponds each body part motions. And each symbol represents part motion, and such as shape is azimuth angle, color is zenith angle, and length is motion duration. For example, this symbol corresponds left wrist pose. And at that moment, left wrist pose is azimuth is left forward, zenith is low, and length is half beat. In fact, this Lava notation is a data compression method along human perception. For example, there is a two dance sequence, and people say, oh, they are same dance, but since each dancer is slightly different motions. So in terms of motion sequence, they are slightly different, yet human perceive them as the same dance. Then, if dancer write it down, those dance in Lava notation, those Lava notation is corresponding. So in that sense, Lava notation is a necessary and sufficient condition to guarantee two motion sequences same in human perception. What is Lava notation? Lava notation is a kind of a digitization, and research says human is not looking at all the motion, rather key poses at certain timing, and that certain timing is corresponding brief stops. So Lava notation only extract pose at brief stop. And secondly, Lava notation digitize space, and according to Miller, human perception digital AD converter is around 7 plus minus 2 batch actually. So along that perception, probably Lava notation 8 azimuth direction and 5 zenith directions. Along this brief stop and the Lava notation spatial digitization, we created Lava notation encoder. From Kinect input, this kind of Lava notation is automatically generated. And we convert that one to the open source called 3D Laban Suite Gesture Authoring 2 and open in the GitHub. So if you are interested, please use. Recently, we convert this 2D Laban notation, Laban Suite to 3D Laban Suite to 2D Laban Suite. And this Laban Suite consists of a pipeline of CMU OpenPOSE and MSRA 3D baseline and Laban editors. By combining these three programs, 2D video is converted into Laban notation and can apply this 2D Laban suite to YouTube video or video segmentation. For example, in this video, woman picks up the tip of the pan and then place it. And then from this motion sequence, 2D Laban suite detected brief stop 0.55 seconds and 1.8 seconds. And in fact, at that moment, this 0.55 is corresponding grass pick task, and then 1.8 second point is corresponding place release task. And moreover, 0.55 in order to achieve grass pickup task, a lady took a right elbow place row and right wrist forward row, and then place release task, she took right elbow as right row and right wrist as right forward row, like this shape. Once we obtain this Lava notation, then by interpolating, robot can generate a continuous motion. Now, When you apply this one to manipulation task, you have to achieve dual goals. The reason is object position at execution mode is different from object position from the, at the teaching mode. So we have to achieve hand configuration to satisfy execution mode, while we try to use body configuration at teaching mode. Fortunately, there is a finding. Hand configuration is independent from upper-lower arm movement. Thus, in order to achieve hand configuration, we adjust the hand configuration to grasp the object at execution mode, and then independently apply lower and upper arm configuration referring rubber notation at teaching mode. And then we use wrist and leg to adjust to satisfy the shoulder position given at hand configuration and upper arm configurations. This is a method how we describe and use human bodies. Now, by obtaining such a human body information, what is a good point? This is a solution without human body configurations. Robot takes a strange position and open because a robot has a redundant degrees. However, by imposing rubber notation human postures, a robot opens the fridge like this. Taking this posture has two advantages. First, the robot will have the fewer accident with people around by adopting similar postures. More importantly, the human movements are often optimized for the task sequences. For example, in order to open the door, we can take two postures, without rubber notation and with rubber notation. And with rubber notation, both postures can achieve the same task. Yet, with rubber notation, we can quickly take a look at inside and avoid collisions. And by considering rubber notation, we can avoid to fill in this kind of infinite loop. So we are pushing this rubber notation for using learning from observation. Now, second issue is semantic constraint, common sense representation in two environmental relations. In order to consider, we have to worry about whether previous six states is enough or not. And in fact, you know, in order to check, we come back the face contact relation. Let's suppose object is sitting on the table. This object can move only upward directions. Such movable direction can be represented as the northern hemisphere of the Gaussian spheres. Southern hemisphere is corresponding to downward, and that direction is prohibited. So by representing this kind of movable direction on the Gaussian sphere, we can classify solution area topologically in these seven classes. Non-contact translation moving freely, planar contact only upward direction, two-side planar contact only along this particular plane like that. Similarly, in rotation case, rotation axis in this is a rotation center and this is a contact point. And then, you know, possible rotation axis is eastern hemisphere and western hemisphere is prohibited rotation because you can only rotate clockwise, counterclockwise, you cannot rotate. Like this on the Gaussian sphere, we can have this solution areas and we have seven states. So among these seven translation and seven rotation, we can find 26 translation tasks and 30 rotation tasks. So this is the basic representation of face contact. Now, let's take a look at the common sense. And in order to achieve some household tasks, we need a common sense knowledge. For example, wiping do not detach from the table surface. In fact, you know, physically, this sponge can move upward directions. So theoretically, physically, this sponge has PC contact, movable upward direction. However, if we move upward, we cannot achieve wiping. So in order to wiping, we are introducing semantic surface to constrain motion of this object. And then we end up by introducing this semantic constraint, movable direction is a two-sided planar contact, TR. Another example, when you have the cup, you can rotate freely if that is on the air. However, if that cup has, say, tomato juice, if we rotate arbitrarily, we may avoid, we may spill the tomato juice. So in order to avoid spill the tomato juice by only rotating around particular direction, revolute rotation, RV. So physically, this cup has a NR state. However, by introducing tomato juice shouldn't be spoiled, spilled, the state become revolute rotations. So we are saying this semantic pin is a semantic constraint. By checking YouTube, we have found semantic pin, semantic wall, semantic tube, semantic sphere, semantic hinge, and semantic box. And corresponding to these semantic constraint, we prepare daemon to collect such a semantic constraint parameters. And we embedded them in the task models. Third issue, from where such semantic constraints come from? In terms of motion, there is no difference in apparent motion, wiping and greeting. Again, such a semantic constraint come from verbal input. Wipe, it means semantic words, something like that. So by observing this scene and verbal instruction wipe table, by using 2D Laban suite, we extract the task, Laban notation, and then corresponding grounding the task. And then to this grounded segment, we apply daemon function and complete the task model. And by using this task model, we can execute this kind of demonstration. Similar story. By pour the juice and then observe this video sequence, and then from this action, 2D Laban editor, 2D Laban suite extract the task sequence and Laban notation, and then to grounded the segment, task model is applied, and necessary parameter is collected, and then executed. Third component. Now we have to grab, and at that time, even though we grab the same object, pen, depending on the purpose, grasping strategy is different. When you have to apply power, you have to grasp like this, so-called power grasping. And when you pointing by using that pen, stability is necessary. So people use so-called precision grasping. And then when you writing, we need the versatility. So people are using intermediate grasping. So again, depending on the task, we have to change the grasping type, and such common sense can only be given from demonstration. Now, how to describe this task and how to execute the grasping task is issues. And grasping task, there is a taxonomy, and then so when there is an input video, we prepare the task and grasp recognition program to classify input image into one of the grasping type. However, depending on the hand configurations, realized grasping is slightly different. So to each grasping type, by using virtual finger theory and closure theory, we prepare so-called contact web, where we should touch that object by using this particular robot hand. And between this demonstration and execution, we prepare loose connection. Teaching mode, we only determine which contact web should be used. And then, based on that contact web, we invoke one of the pipeline, end-to-end pipeline, from image to robot hand. If realized contact web, recognized contact web is A, only this pipeline is executed. Now, let's take a look at this contact web-based glass pipeline. This contact web-based pipeline consists of two pipelines. One is a pre-trained visual cortex to determine contact web from input Kinect data. And another component is a pre-trained bonsai cerebellum, which executes recognized contact web on robot hardware. This pre-trained visual cortex is relatively easy. By using depth image and contact wave information, we train seven layers network. Now, pre-trained bonsai cerebellum, we use a bonsai reinforcement learning system to train bonsai brains. As an initial hint, contact wave and hand directions, and state, finger positions, and contact force directions. And then reward is success and failure, and we can obtain this kind of grasp system. One of the bonus is the same cerebrum to train to particular size of object can handle different size of object due to the force feedback procedures. Another bonus, even though our cerebrum is trained cylindrical object, yet they can grasp different shaped object. So currently we are investing how many pipeline do we need to cover entire space shape, entire shape space, and entire contact web. So today, I was talking about the task model and baseline system and three tools, Laba notation to represent common sense in body motions, semantic constraint to represent common sense in two environmental relations, and the contact web to represent grasping. This work is done not only by me, but also our team's member, David Baumart, John Takamatsu, Jun Takamatsu, and Kazuhiro Sasabuchi, and Naoki Wake, as well as former member and our long-term intern. Thank you very much.